The next section we'll be discussing is MOG and aging. This is for Dr. Chitnis. What do we know about the transition from childhood to adulthood, specifically as kids hit puberty? Are they likely to transition away from encephalitis or ADEM to more ONTM? What else might happen?
Yes, so this is a very important question. So what we do know is that younger children, so between the ages of typically 2 and 7 years old, tend to have ADEM as their presenting symptom of MOGAD. And these children tend to not relapse, so there's a very low risk of relapsing in the future. There is a present relapse risk, but it's very small. When children are older, so around 10 to 12 or 10 to 15, they're more likely to have optic neuritis as a presenting symptom. And these kids can have a slightly higher risk of relapsing, and this is now being assessed, you know, what exactly is their risk of having a relapse. It's also important to remember that some of these kids can present with bilateral optic neuritis or optic neuritis that starts in one eye and then follows in a second eye, so it's very important to continue to monitor those young kids. And as children get a little bit older, and older kids, we tend to see a bit more transverse myelitis presentations, and there's a slight male predominance to that as well. So we start to see some sex differences as well in the presentations in children who are postpubertal, so after age 10 or so. And then in even older teenagers and young adults, then we start to see more NMO presentations. And however, everything I just said, there's always an exception to the rule. So we, you know, I just saw a gentleman with ADEM who is about 35 or so, and so there's many exceptions to these rules. But that's in general what we see. So the phenotype does change with age and also with the transition to puberty or through puberty. And there may be a role of sex hormones here. And so there's a lot of work to be done in understanding the role of estrogens, which we know are pro-inflammatory in many cases and might lead to these different phenotypes. I think another important question that still needs to be answered fully is whether after puberty, children who had a maybe ADEM presentation or an early optic neuritis presentation will have more frequent relapses. So that needs to be fully assessed. And just anecdotally, I've seen some kids shortly after puberty will have another attack. And so that might herald or be a sign that they do have relapsing MOGAD. So I think we still need to do a bit more work in this area.